Were you aware that more than 85,000 people ran away from Yemen due to all the violence? This is all because of the attacks that have been taking place on the country. They cause people to flee for their lives. Other countries, just like Yemen, have been losing people because of the horrible things taking place. Those people don't have a choice. They can't just live their life in all bad conditions. They are forced to flee their country. This is why tonight I'm going to talk about how we should and can help people suffering from tragedies, which leave them no choice but to run away. Whenever I watch TV, an ad book on about this organization, about the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees Agency, also known as UNHCR. It provides resources for people that run away from the country. One story that stood out to me was about a girl named Ella. She was playing outside her home and a bomb exploded. She was just a toddler. It was so tragic that she did not speak ever since. When I saw this, I felt like crying because there are people facing so many problems and need a solution. They should be assured of safety from anybody or organization. I read about another story from the organization, the International Rescue Committee, also known as the IRC. It was about a family that ran from Afghanistan to Greece because they were threatened. They had to leave because their children were in danger. They lost all their belongings and money, and they would have died. They had a fresh new start once they found people that could help them. There are many reasons why people run away. It can be because of war, violence, and many other disasters that occur. According to the website Amnesty International, governments should never force anyone to go back to a country where they are at risk of human rights violations. Instead, refugees should be offered a safe place to live and opportunities to work, a place to live and access to schooling and healthcare. I strongly believe that refugees should be offered as the government should not send refugees back to their countries and instead should welcome them into their country with care. The Trump policy for refugees puts 11 places in the world at risk on a watch list, which can stop refugees from entering the United States. This policy stops refugees from even trying the right way. So thinking about their health and safety, I'm going to give you some ways to help. Something you can do is go to either websites or both, UNHCR.org and Rescue.org, and donate money to the refugees that need it. Also, you can help raise awareness of people that run away by starting campaigns and volunteering. This topic is very important for kids my age to think about because they can see what it feels like to walk in refugee shoes. They can think about what it feels like to be driven away from their country and to lose so much. I found that 28,300 people leave their homes a day because of the conflict. Isn't that crazy? That so many people have to leave everything behind because of the way they are treated? Also, according to UNHCR.org, 65.6 million people are forcibly displaced worldwide. In conclusion, I'm here tonight to explain to you that we should thank God for giving us this life. We shouldn't worry about little things that go wrong in our lives. Instead, we should think about others. We should think about those whose lives are turning upside down by the second, those who do not have food to eat, a roof to live under, and clothes to wear. Please don't hesitate to save a life and spread the word. Thank you and have a great rest of your evening.